FreeRTOS interrupts and connection to hardware. Now we need to focus on one of the main important aspects of FreeRTOS implementation, its cooperation with hardware interrupts.
Let's discuss about the FreeRTOS operating system interrupts. So PentestV interrupt, it is a software interrupt which is used to switch the context between one task to the other. As it is a software interrupt, it can be triggered by the software from other interrupt or from the user code. In practice, it is called usually by the SysTick, which is the timer, which is trying to give the same amount of the time for each task which should be executed. And then PentestV can be triggered as well by the kernel in case the task will finalize each job before this time. And it can be triggered by kernel as well, in case there is the new task with higher priority with currently executed one. So in this case, PentestV is switching the context from the lower priority task to the higher priority task and start executing the new task. SVC interrupt, it is again the software interrupt which is called only once at the beginning of the application execution to start the scheduler. It is done within the port start first task function. I already mentioned SysTick timer and its interrupt. It is used to give us the regular time slice for each task and is triggering, it's calling the PentestV interrupt to switch the context. Please remember that PentestV and SysTick has the lowest possible NVIC priority level due to the fact that we don't need to have any negative interaction between those two and the other interrupts, and because it is not good if operating system is blocking somehow or is delaying the hardware interrupts of the system. This is why PentestV and SysTick has the lowest possible interrupt level within the system. NVIC configuration. To configure FreeRTOS within the application, it is necessary to split all the interrupts into the three groups. Non-RTOS IRQs, so non-RTOS interrupts, which should consist of most important interrupts, which cannot be interrupted or delayed by operating system and cannot execute any operating system code. RTOS interrupts, so the interrupts which can be delayed or interrupted by the operating system and can execute operating system code, and kernel interrupts, which consist of two interrupts, SysTicks and PentestV, responsible for context switch. Those should be the least important ones, allowing rest of the hardware work like there is no operating system. To specify those three groups, we need to specify two borders. In fact, the first one is quite flexible. Config max syscall interrupt priority between first two and config kernel interrupt priority, which is the lowest possible priority in the interrupt system specified by the core implementation. Both of them are stored within the FreeRTOS config.h file and can be modified from FreeRTOS config section within STM32CubeMX or STM32CubeIDE. Few words about the practical implementation within STM32 lines. Lowest NVIC interrupt priority within Cortex-M0 and M0 Plus based devices, so for example STM32 F0, G0 or L0 is set to 3, while the lowest NVIC interrupt priority for Cortex-M3, M4 and M7 devices, like for example STM32 F1, F2, F3, F4, F7, H7, and low power, like L1, L4, is set to 15. Let's have a look what is happening once we execute OS function from the interrupt procedure. So within FreeRTOS API, there are dedicated functions to be executed within IRQ procedures. All of those functions has from ISR suffix in its name, like xSemaphoreGive from ISR, what we can see on the screen. The only difference for the programmer is an additional argument, which is the pointer to the variable, which is used to indicate whether operation on the queue or semaphore within IRQ causes unblocking of the task with higher priority than currently executed. If this parameter is true, there is a need of context switch by calling PentestV interrupt before the kernel will exit from the currently executed interrupt. And here on the screen we can see the illustration of such a situation.
We have two tasks, task A, green one, and task D. Task D has a higher priority than A, but it is currently in a blocked state as it is waiting for one of the semaphores. During execution of task A, there is interrupt coming called IRQ1, which is releasing the semaphore which was requested by task D. So, the kernel is informed about this situation and is calling dependSV interrupt to switch the context between task A and task D. So, in fact, we are coming back from the interrupt IRQ1 to the interrupt pendSV, which is switching the context from task A to task D. We are executing the code of task D, which has the higher priority than task A. And then at the end of this execution, within the task code, there is a function OSDelay. Function OSDelay means that task D is deciding to go into the blocked state for some certain time. It's some delay. It's waiting for some timeout. It is again causing the next call of pendSV interrupt because task D is not anymore in a ready state. It is in a blocked state. So we can come back to previously removed task A. So pendSV is performing the switching of the context between task D to task A, and task A can be executed again.
Thank you for watching this video.